Hello students, welcome back to social studies class. As you know that we were reading about the grasslands of the temperate zone in our last class. We will going to conduct that lesson today in our today's class, and we are going to complete the explanation part of that lesson today. So my name is Abhishek Pratap Singh and I am doing good, and I hope you too doing good at your places. Now students, let's start the class of today and let's see that what we need to have in today's class. So I have written few things on board and we will explain these all things in today's class. So those are, recall the last learning. We will just going to have a fast recap of our last learning, and then after that we will just look at the words map for the grasslands, which what where are the grasslands present on the world map again, as we have done in the last class. Understanding its agriculture and the rearing cattle, like these two parts we need to understand in today's classes. So students, let's get started. So now students, we have to just go through what we have read in our last class again. Okay, so as I have just opened that page only from where we have to start. So let me just recall the things again. So grasslands are the vast stretches of land covered with the tall grasses and a few scattered trees over it. So as we have already discussed these things, that it's a large area of land is covered with grasses, right? These are tall grasses and we don't have trees over it, right? We have only few scattered trees, which are not dense in their look. Now the grasslands cover more than 1/5 of the earth's land surface, means out of that earth surface, out of that complete earth surface, grassland has a 1/5 area of the total earth's area, right? Most of these grasslands are located in the temperate zone, and maximum of the grasslands are there in the temperate zone. And if you talk about the degrees of temperate zone, so that is the latitude between 23.5 degree north and 66.5 degree north. Okay, that is for the northern hemisphere, and same for the southern hemisphere. The grasslands are known by different names in different parts of the world. So, and this lesson we are going to focus on the North America's grassland, that is called prairies. Okay, so students, let me just zoom into this world's map so that you can just have a view and you can just understand that where are the grasslands present on the world map. So you can see that the grasslands of the world, okay, and you can, as the green area which is visible there, these all are grasslands. And as we have discussed that maximum of the grasslands are there in the temperate zone. So here from this Tropic of Cancer till the Arctic Circle, that is 66.5 degree north and 33.5 degree north, that is the Tropic of Cancer, and we can see the grasslands here in this zone, which is a temperate zone. Okay, and so these are the grasslands, and you can see few grasslands as there in the again temperate zone of the southern hemisphere, and few are there located on the equatorial region, right? So like this, these are the locations of the grasslands. Let's read out that what are the names of the different grasslands. Here prairies, pampas, wilds, downs, and here we have steppes. Okay, and different grasslands, like these are the grasslands. So students, after this we are just going to have read the things regarding its rearing cattle and the agriculture part. So students, as you know, we have to read about agriculture of the temperate zone, like especially of prairies, which is present in North America. So the soil here is fertile. Water is available in plenty from the Mississippi and the Missouri rivers and their tributaries. Now the soil is fertile here, okay, means we can go for a good agriculture, right? We can have a good cultivation of crops. Water is available in plenty from the Mississippi and the Missouri rivers and their tributaries, which means there are two rivers from which it is, this area is getting water, and their tributaries. Now what are tributaries, students? Tributaries are the little streams, or the little stream of water is coming out from these rivers only, okay? So their tributaries and these two rivers are helping this area to keep its availability of water is there because of these two rivers. This makes it perfect for agriculture, right? So these all situation is making the place perfect for agriculture. The region produces so much of wheat, that is, it is called the wheat basket food world. And this region is producing large quantity of wheat. That's why we calling, like that's why we call this place is as a wheat basket of the world, right? All over the world, this place is cultivating a huge amount of, or the large amount of wheat. It makes the United States of America the largest because of this wheat basket of the world, because of these conditions and the production of the huge wheat or like the maximum wheat, they are the America, the USA, we are the largest exporters of wheat in the world. The main other crops grown are maize, barley, rye and oats. Now what is rye? Rye is a kind of a cereal. Farm work such as plugging, sowing, harvesting, threshing is done with the help of machine. So they have the technologies and well-equipped machines which are doing such work in the farmlands. The farmers who are mostly European settlers generally live on their huge farms with their families, and people are generally looking after the farming are mostly Europeans, and they have set up their families at their farm only. The workers also live on the farms, and the workers who work in that farm field or the field, they also live there on the farm only. Since the farms are huge and machines do the most of the work, the population in the region is thin. And because of the lot of work is done by machines only, and the farms are quite huge as well, so there is a population which is very thin. Means like there is a very medium population, like not very much populated area is this. So there is a very very thin population is there. Let's talk about the area of cattle in temperate zone, means in prairies. So towards the west, the prairies are hilly, and the south soil is not so fertile. These areas are mainly used to rear cattle in large farms called ranches. Now, in the west side of the north prairies, or which is present in the North America, the prairies are hilly, means they have a little mountains, okay, and the soil is not so much fertile, which is capable of doing cultivation of crops. So these areas are mainly used for the grazing purpose, or like for the rear cattle in large farms. Those areas are called ranches. Cattle are raised for beef and dairy products, and they just rear cattle for the beef purpose, for their meat and for their dairy product. The cattle are sent to slaughter houses in the cities for the production of beef. And after rearing or after raising the cattle, they send this their cattle to the slaughterhouse in the city for the production of beef or mutton. The city of Chicago is an important center for slaughtering animals. Now, the city of Chicago is the main junction or the main place where a lot of slaughterhouses are there, and it acts as an important center for the slaughtering of animals, like especially these cattle. Ranches and slaughterhouses are equipped with modern machinery. And what is happening there? Like the slaughterhouses which cuts the animals, okay, it is done by the help of the machines, and the modern machines are there in the slaughterhouse. So students, this is all for this lesson we have done with the explanation part. We will cover up exercises and solve the question answers in our next class. Till that time, be with us, keep on watching videos, and stay safe at your places. Thank you so much.